Hi everyone, welcome back to Challenge Learning Turkish, session 34. In this session, I am going to speak about two verbal adjective suffixes and their forms depending on the vowel letter of the verb root. Okay, let's move on to the next slide now. Verbal adjective suffixes, which will be the main topic of this session, is er and ar. Verbal adjective suffixes are named as sıfat fiil ekleri in Turkish, er, ar. These verbal adjective suffixes are attached to the verb roots to produce adjectival words, that is verbal adjectives with an aorist, that is white tense meaning. Sometimes they may also form ordinary and compound names. Adjective and nouns formed in this way describes ongoing innate tendency or habitual activities. Now let's see how to form affirmative structure. In the first place, there is verb root. Next is the verbal adjective suffixes to be added to the verb root, er and ar. They takes the form ir or just re, er, ur, ur, depending on the vowel letter of the verb root. Please refer to the slide about simple present tense in Turkish language. Then you can see here how you form these suffixes depending on the verb root's vowel letter. And finally, there is noun described by verbal adjective. So let's see the example now. Our example verb is çalmak, which means to ring. Alarm to sound, play, chime, they are very equal to each other in terms of meaning, except still. So, çalmak has more than one meaning in English. So, it can have either the meaning ring or alarm to sound or still. So our verb root here is çal. We'll use the meaning alarm to sound here. So we produce from the verb root çal the verbal adjective çalar by using our suffix here, and noun saat, clock, çalar saat, which translates as alarm clock. So let's see this çalar saat in sentence now. Uyumadan önce çalar saati sabah saat 7'ye kurmayı unutma. Uyumadan önce, before sleeping, çalar saati, alarming clock, sabah saat 7'ye, at 7 a.m. in the morning, kurmayı unutma, don't forget to set. Uyumadan önce çalar saati sabah saat 7'ye kurmayı unutma, don't forget to set the alarm clock for 7 a.m. before going to sleep. Our next sample verb is akmak, which means to flow or to run. As synonym, our verb root is ak. So our verbal adjective, which is derived from verb root ak, is akar. So it describes the noun su, here water. Akar su, which translates as running water or flowing water or stream. So it makes sense as opposed to stagnate or dead water. Akarsu kir tutmaz, or a synonym, akarsu pislik tutmaz. So kir and pislik here have the same meaning, synonym meaning. Running water does not accumulate dirt. Flowing water does not accumulate dirt. Or as different translation, it would be running water is dirt repellent or dirt proof. Our verb is gülmek, to smile or to laugh. Verb root is gül. So derived verbal adjective here is güler. Described noun, yüz, face, güler yüz, smiling face. Güler yüzlü olan kişi herkes tarafından sevilir. Güler yüzlü olan kişi herkes tarafından sevilir. Person with a smiling face is well liked by everyone. Güler yüzlü olan kişi herkes tarafından sevilir. Next verb is uyumak, to sleep. Verb root is uyu. So derived verbal adjective here is uyur. So since the last vowel letter of the verb root is u and the verb root ends with vowel letter, we just use the letter re instead of er or ar and their derivatives. Uyur, gezer, sleep, walker. Bir uyur gezeri uyandırırsanız ne olur? Uyur, gezer. Bir uyur gezeri uyandırırsanız ne olur? What happens when you wake up a sleepwalker? Next verb is yanmak, which translates as to burn or glow or light. The verb root is yan, yanar da. Or a synonym to yanardağ, we can just use volkan, which is very similar in terms of sound to the English name volcano or burning mountain. A mountain that has been erupting or erupted in the past. Hasan Dağı Türkiye'deki sönmüş yanardağlardan birisidir. Hasan Dağı Türkiye'deki sönmüş yanardağlardan birisidir. Mount Hasan is one of the extinct volcanoes in Turkey. Sönmüş here refers to extinct, sönmüş yanardağ, extinct volcano. Next verb is kırılmak, be broken, crash. Verb root kırıl. Kırılır eşya, breakable item, fragile item. Hava yolları kırılır eşyalar için ekstra ücret talep ederler. Hava yolları kırılır eşyalar için ekstra ücret talep ederler. Airlines charge extra fee for fragile items. Our verb is yüzmek, to swim. Verb root is yüz. So we add er suffix to the verb root and we obtain yüzer, which means floating. So the noun to be described here is otel or hotel. So yüzer otel, flotel or floating hotel. Denizin üstüne yüzer otel inşa ediyorlar. denizin üstüne yüzer otel inşa ediyorlar. They are building a floating hotel on the sea. So our verb here is yazmak, to write. Our verb root is yaz. This time we produce here both noun and verbal adjective. So yazar itself becomes noun, which has the meaning writer or author. So as verbal adjective, it describes here kasa, register, yazar kasa, cash register. Yazar kasa, cash register. So we obtain both noun and verbal adjective here from the suffixes er and ar. Her mükellef için yazar kasa kullanımı zorunludur. Her mükellef için yazar kasa kullanımı zorunludur. It translates as use of cash register is obligatory for every taxpayers. Use of cash register is obligatory for every taxpayers. Her mükellef için yazar kasa kullanımı zorunludur. Zorunludur here means obligatory. Now let's see the structure of negative form. In the first place, again, there is verb root, but as different from the affirmative form, this time we add the suffixes mez or maz instead of er or ar. So next is the noun, which will be described by the verbal adjective. So these give the sense of negativity. Our example is here yorulmak, which is translated as be tired, be fatigued, get tired, exhaust. Our verb root here is yorul after removing mak. So we add here maz suffix, again depending on the verb root vowel letter. So it becomes yorulmaz kişi, indefatigable or tireless or inexhaustible person. Onun gibi yorulmaz bir kişiyi daha önce hiç görmedim. Onun gibi, like him, yorulmaz bir kişiyi, indefatigable person, daha önce, before, hiç görmedim, never seen. I have never seen an indefatigable person like him before. Onun gibi yorulmaz bir kişiyi daha önce hiç görmedim. Our verb again here, just as the affirmative form usage, gülmek, to smile, to laugh. Our verb root here is gül. So this time it becomes gülmez when added mez. So noun is yüz, gülmez yüz, unsmiling face, or a synonym we can replace in usage this verbal adjective with sullen, sullen face, but we'll use here unsmiling face in our sentence. O her zaman gülmez yüze sahip. O her zaman gülmez yüze sahip. She or he has always unsmiling face. Our verb geçirmek In this sense, it translates as to pass, make pass, or get through. Our verb root here is geç. Su geçirmez ayakkabı. This time we add suffix mez instead of maz, depending on the vowel letter of the verb root. So here I am correcting my mistake. Our verb root is geçir instead of geç. It must be geçir after removing mek. Su geçirmez ayakkabı. Waterproof or repellent shoes. Su geçirmez ayakkabı. So ayakkabı is the noun described by su geçirmez. Karda yürümek için su geçirmez ayakkabı giymen gerekiyor. Karda yürümek için su geçirmez ayakkabı giymen gerekiyor. You need to wear a waterproof shoe to walk on the snow. Karda yürümek için su geçirmez ayakkabı giymen gerekiyor. Our next verb is paslanmak, which translates as to rust or rot, oxidate. Verb root is paslan. Paslanmaz çelik. This time it becomes stainless or non-rusting steel. So stainless steel or non-rusting steel. Bu çaydanlık paslanmaz çelikten yapılmıştır. Or bu çaydanlık paslanmaz çelikten imal edilmiştir. So yapılmıştır and imal edilmiştir can be used interchangeably as synonym words. The teapot is made up of stainless steel. Or this teapot is made up of stainless steel. So our verb is ölmek, to die. Our verb root is öl. So by adding mez suffix, it becomes ölmez, immortal. So eser, work or piece. Ölmez eser, an immortal work or piece. Mimar Sinan, who is one of the greatest architects in Turkish and Ottoman history. So Mimar Sinan arkasında birçok ölmez eserler bıraktı. Mimar Sinan arkasında birçok ölmez eserler bıraktı. Architect Sinan left many immortal works behind him. Mimar, architect, Sinan arkasında, behind him, birçok, many immortal works, ölmez eserler bıraktı, left. Mimar Sinan arkasında birçok ölmez eserler bıraktı. Okay guys, again we are on the closing phase of our session again, and the closing idiom of the session is bal tutan parmağını yalar. Bal tutan parmağını yalar. Which translates as someone who has something to do with a big deal will always take a share of the goods. Bal tutan parmağını yalar. Okay guys, thank you again for listening and being with me during this session. Please don't forget to click on like and subscribe to my channel if you have liked this session. Gelecek slaytta görüşmek üzere. See you on next slide. Gelecek slaytta görüşmek üzere.